Kind of collaborative ALO process yet, and it was really great to sort of go into this thing where like feeling very individualistic, and now I'm feeling back in this collective identity where it's like I have like I'm back with like my friends from when I was 12 years old, you know, and but it feels like it's actually growing into this new thing, and that feels really good.
As ALO does, we're exploring lots of different styles, some more rockin' styles.
Steve really had a connection with the steel drum, which is awesome.
Pedal steel guitar, I've been using that a bunch on this recording. Actually, an instrument I've always really loved. Man, it's one of those things that just sucks you in.
I've done a little bit of congas on one song on a couple of albums ago, but it's never been like featured. Like, there's gonna be a lot of congas on this.
Just get back to that spirit of what made all this fun. Let's you know, be kids again in a space playing music.
One direction this album is taking is there's like a real playful spirit to it, I feel like. And I think also working with Jack, I think he brings in like a certain playfulness as well.
And we thought like, we just don't want to go in. We need somebody else outside of the band who understands the band, appreciates the band. You know, Jack just seemed like the perfect fit for that. Snow
fell down. It's been great having Jack as a producer. It's like exactly what we needed, because you know, we're like four guys all kind of coming from slightly different directions musically, kind of on different musical pages. And Jack's just been great at kind of like synthesizing everyone's sort of tastes and everything, and then bringing in his own sense and taste.
I feel like in the past we haven't really worked too heavily with producers. We've always talked about doing a project like this together, so it was just real natural. It just sort of fell into place like that.
It almost feels like he's like a fifth member of the band.
A band like ALO, it's amazing on their instruments, so to be able to be in the studio and then to see them be able just to go in there and be in one room, not to, you know, a lot of times, you know, in the studio you separate into all these different rooms, and then you also, the drummer will get his beat and the bass will lay on top of that, and you kind of build the song. But these guys are so good, they just get in the same room and then you just pretty much push record and they go and the song's kind of done.
It's been great recording here in Hawaii. I think my favorite part is just when we finish a take, being able to just come outside and just soak in the sun and the beautiful air and just everything. It's really, really cool.
It was a natural fit, and it's actually feels like a refreshing return to kind of an older version of the band being out here.
I remember having like a real dream to like go somewhere remote to do our next record. The last record being in Santa Barbara. Like, but I remember just like feeling like I wanted to be somewhere else, like far away, just to like take in some of that influence and inspiration of some other place. So in that way, I've been really excited to be here.
It's sort of neutral ground for everyone, which is cool, because we all, whenever we do it in a place where we live, you know, but usually we do the album in one of our towns, you know, like either in the Bay Area, you know, where some of us live, or down in Santa Barbara where Zach is. It's been cool to all just be out here where we're like all away from our home life, in a sense where, you know, you can just kind of like get into that space without, you're kind of forced to break from your typical routine, I guess. You know, you're put in a new position, so it kind of inspires you to do new things.
The first time we've recorded an album, we're not worrying about isolation of the instruments, which kind of, it's a little bit technical, but usually everybody's separated, and so that if one person makes a mistake, it doesn't matter.
On the first two records, it was really, we thought of like building the songs up from the drums up, you know. We'd go onto the computer right then and like start pulling it apart with Pro Tools and slicing drum hits and moving them over and lining things up.
It is what it is, you know? Like however we performed it in that moment is what it is, you know, no editing or anything like that.
We keep focusing on a capturing of a vibe. And like, wow, you guys feeling this in the room? Like everyone's
right.
Excited and like, press record, we're going, you know? And we've actually been able to capture that, which in the past I felt like things were a little more textbooky or something.
Sure,
you know,
definitely.
It was more like, let's do this, and it's, you know, more like building a house, as opposed to now we're just, feels more like we're like painting with like splatters together or something.
I think people are gonna kind of, it's gonna like turn people's ears a little bit and like get them excited about what we're doing.
I feel like we're getting our thing, and it feels less derivative of something else and more like its own thing, which is an exciting feeling. You know, there's things on there that don't sound like, you know, a lot of times you're like, oh, this is kind of like that kind of a song, but there's a lot of things on the on this album that don't sound like anything else to me. He's a man of the world, but he knows.